Do you ever think that we have it too easy today? You know, as you grew up, and also as I grew up, I remember selling newspapers and doing anything.
I don't think life can be too easy. I think it's always one hassle or another. And I think the form of the drive may have changed. I mean, where you and I were dealing with our hands manually, they're dealing with computers. Now, I think in one respect, we may take out the meat of the control, because I know a man that flies a 747 don't enjoy flying as much as a cat flying a Piper Cub. But by the same token, they're going the same place. But the job with the big carriers, because you got commercial people, you got a lot of people there who don't want the jolting, who's afraid, who's probably the first time we're going in the air. So we just have to kind of keep it going together.
Well, what I'm thinking of more or less is today we seem to take things for granted.
Well, we deal with what we see. We don't see the hard times that we saw a long time ago. So we deal with the same things. If you'd come along and I'd come along with a different kind of concept, a different way of survival, then we would have addressed ourselves and would have neutralized ourselves and become a part of our environment. So what they're doing to become a part of the environment, you don't expect a man to apply a mule when he don't even see a farm.
You keep a very busy schedule. How busy is your schedule in life?
As busy as God wanted to be.
You're on tour now in San Francisco. Is this just one of many cities, or how
so active are you in a year? Well, this is part of living. You know, becoming a legend in your own time is very fruitful and very nice. I was just visiting today KJAZZ, a very fantastic dynamic station. It has a complete broad scope of what's going on. I visited another station earlier, and they said they didn't do on the interviews, which were very stupid, because the station should have did it, because they're depriving the public of what's happening. That's mean I'm so glad that you're here, because you give them that base. And when a station get too big to interview people, they're stupid. They don't know what's going on. KJAZZ accepted me, and not only did they interview me and put me on the air, but he gave me a bottle of wine because they want the blood to keep flowing. So, hey, drink this wine and keep doing what you're doing. And that's the station I would advise most people in this area to stay tuned to. One that's concerned, one that brings you to the public like you're bringing them. I am a KJAZZ fan. I want everybody to know that openly.
I know. I'm not going to mention the station that you're talking about.
But they're stupid. Look, I remember we helped build that chain of stations. The name changes, but the station is the same. You know, the station that I went to is actually the other band to KSAN years ago, when Rockin' Luck and all the people on there. And that was the FM side. They don't know they have obligations to the people. When you're not serving the people, you shouldn't be on the air. You know, like a friend of mine, Frank Crocker, said, if you don't stay tuned to me, if your radio is not on this station, and I figure if your radio is not on a station that talks to all people and give the people what they want in terms of giving people what you want them to have, I mean, you can't make people a slave to your thoughts. You got to let people make their own choice. If I want to hear B.B. King, a Bobby Bland, a Montavani, Charlotte Pride, and Tony Bennett, let me hear what I want to hear. And when you deprive me of that, you don't need the license.
I understand.
Segregation can be used in so many forms. When you don't let people hear, they want to hear James Brown, who most people are copying today, then you're depriving people. I don't see the need for the station to be on air if you're not going to serve the people. And I can challenge that.
I'm on your side.
Take it off the air.
All right.
Take it off the air. Change the management. Fast.
It's the all.
And tell them I said it.
I think the people need...
We need a people's station. We need people's stations.
There is a people's station, but the people don't listen to it. They listen to... Today we are so free to... Everyone's playing everything.
Well, I like KJAZZ. I like KDIA. I like KYA. I'm not just saying that, but I'm a jazz-orientated person. I like techniques, and I like the highest form of artistical thoughts and views and concept of music. So I listen to KJAZZ because they go on with it. They get on to the way it's going. They're not trying to hold people back and put them in a bag. That you listen to everything. Now, on my new album, Bring It On, we got the Tennessee Waltz on that. James Brown doing the Tennessee Waltz. Because I was the first soul singer to go to the Grand Ole Opry. Then we got Nighttime at the Right Time. Then we got Your Precious Love, where I reminisce about Jackie Wilson and Chuck Jackson. And Jackie just passed. God bless his soul. And all about Jackie Wilson fans. You know, I'm James Brown, but I was a Jackie Wilson fan. He was my brother. And I loved him very much. Same as Jimmy Nolan that played with me for 21 years. He just passed about 3.5 weeks ago. These are people that made contribution to the world of music, which is a universal language of love and understanding. Don't let me keep on talking, brother.
We're going to be showing a video of yours called Night Train in the next couple of weeks. I hope to have it so I can air it with the.
There is another video going around on TV, and they will. You can call Danny O'Donovan in Los Angeles, and that's DOD production. That's me, BB King, and Michael Jackson. You should get a copy of Doing It to Death and run that. You have my permission. You tell Danny I tell you to run it because we need for them to see that. And your program is a great concept and it's doing a lot of good. And I love what the station's doing.
BB King.
Channel 48 to me is very important.
BB King, Ollie, we're trying to bridge. We play Lionel Richie
like
as the kids popping and doing the thing. And we love it to see the adults finding out what they don't, sometimes they don't understand what the kids
well,
are
Well, let me say something to you. I'm a world artist, and a lot of things I don't get a chance to do in America. I was at K-Jazz earlier, and I came out on the street, and people that didn't have a color, so it was everybody, you know. I see the Spanish brothers, I saw the Irish brothers, I saw the Italian, the Jew, the Afro-Americans, the Indians, I saw people, I saw the Orientals going crazy over James Brown, and they said, hey, we want soul, and that's what it's about. So this is what I was going to say is, thank God I don't have a age limit. Last September, we played to 1,003,000 people, the biggest crowd to ever go out and witness a show in history, 3 times bigger than Woodstock. So the only reason you don't hear me on a lot of the stations that specialize into the one area of music is like what you said. They don't get a chance to know the whole structure. So when you see a Lionel Richie or Michael Jackson or Prince, and they're into him, I love it. And I love to see it because somebody has to talk to everybody at all times.